This program contains images that are graphic in nature. Some scenes may also contain recreations. Viewer discretion is advised. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of A Day in My Life. Tonight, you're going to go on a venture with me through an inspection with the USDA. Yep, you heard me right. It's time to spend 7 hours of my day with people that know nothing about animals.
Do you have a schedule for how you're going to do the rest of them, or is it just kind
of... Well, we've been going by the younger cats first that aren't declawed. Okay. And that's the way Nancy had us working on it, was kind of like Lori just said, you know, your geriatric cats that are limping.
So kind of a risk-based.
Right.
I think that's an appropriate way to do it.
Time to have to make me raise all my cages because they don't know what they're doing. Lynch, you're not eating your turkey.
So what's the diet for you guys?
Everybody has, during the summertime when it's so hot and they don't eat so much, we have them on 8 pounds, bags a day.
8 pounds of?
It's a mixture between the red beef, chicken. We don't feed anything, just chicken or just beef.
Okay.
And then during this time of year when it's cooler and they can put on a little bit more weight for the winter without throwing up because it's so hot,
yep.
We bump them up to 12 pounds.
So they get 12 pounds and then one fast day?
Right.
Uh-huh. And so they get 12 pounds of a mix of a beef and a whole chicken. And does the beef have bones in it?
Yep, or? Yep. So that's why we just threw 4 foot straight up.
That's more secure too, the way you're doing it.
Going higher.
Going higher and leaving the kick in. I mean, the two, the combination of those, I don't think people could argue that it would be extremely difficult for an animal to get out of that, I think.
These are the bear hams.
Okay.
How long does it stay in the freezer now, 4 cheese?
We empty this twice a week. Because our meat truck comes in, every Monday and every Friday.
I just, as long as you're emptying it fast, that's fine. Yeah, I'd be concerned with that much in there that maybe some of it's not staying.
Gets bad, yeah.
But if you're going through it pretty quick, it's fine.
Yeah, we empty this completely out twice a week. Believe it or not, you know, it's a shame that other facilities, see, here's the hooks.
Oh, all right. There is one of these.
Every cart has two of them. Yep. We use bull hooks. We have 2 bull hooks on almost every cart, so that way the staff members can reach into the cage, hook the doors without ever sticking their hands in them. And these guys gotta take pictures of them. Now the tiger that we had this accident with is still in, we moved to the back because, well,
these are your lockouts.
Yeah, these are the lockouts, and all of them, you know, nope. We've left it completely empty until everybody's investigations are over. But let's see, we have, every crew has a 4 foot stick with a hook on the end.
they carry that with them inside with that hand inside.
Like I haven't explained this to enough people, now I got to go through the complete accident with SAF again and explain to the big cat expert of just how this happened and what went wrong. Yep. Okay, and you're supposed to hook that door to pull that door open so the cat can get in. And then they have the cables to pull the door shut. And then they have these to slide in, and they're never supposed to put their hand in there. She didn't use the hook. And when the cat was in this cage right here, she stuck her hand in here to push the door shut. Okay. And it got her.
She didn't just pull
the door. Yeah. And she's working today. She'll be happy to tell you that she fucked up. When I got here, it was nothing but bones sticking out. And I...
So she had brought the cat in.
Yep.
He locked him in there.
Is the cat still here?
It's in the back. They made us quarantine it. The health department did. She had been here almost a year. She still is my best worker.
Yeah.
Everybody scrutinized me, said that I should have fired her, and I'm like, dude, I mean, what better safety person can you get to teach the future people than somebody that fucked up, you know?
And here's the, you have the feeding chutes for everybody.
Yep.
And then their waters are these.
Right.
And, oh, that guy's not here.
Yeah, we have garden hoses on, you know, everywhere. And it's the same way with these. They have a hook on days that we don't clean, because we're clean every other day.
Right.
Okay. And we fast feed. So the chutes are only used on fast feeding days.
Okay.
Right? And they have a hook. What, Bubba? They have a hook that'll hook the front of that to dump it, spray it out, and then refill it. And they... This is the one I told you that digs a hole all the time.
The hook's the same. It's the same one that they use.
Okay. Yep. Not only do you have to explain diets, protocols, and everything that the staff members fuck up in a day to a USDA inspector, but you have to explain every bump, scratch, and bruise that animals get fighting amongst each other when they're the ones that make the law that says you cannot declaw a big cat anymore. What the hell do you think they're going to do? And these two hyenas... We separated them, and they still lay next to the cage and let each other chew on them.
Yep.
We had to raise their... God. Damn, man. Now they're digging, you know, they dig under to get to each other. And I wish that we could find somebody that could tell me if they're boys or girls, because Doc Green doesn't know how to tell.
But Gage, what do you think? Are you able to sex a hyena?
It's really tough to sex a hyena. I was going to try to guess that if this were the male or the female based on the bite marks on
them. We bought them as a pair.
Yeah.
Okay. And let me tell you, whatever this is, we'll find any means possible to get over there. I mean, we even had to double the fence because she would lay against the fence and let the other one chew her up. It's like, how stupid can you be?
Yeah. They're so frequently. Bites, but not always.
You could see it if they were in the same cage,
yep.
But she would lay against the fence and let this one chew her up.
They are an interesting creature. Are they related?
Well, they're supposed to have came in as an unrelated pair straight from Africa.
Oh, from Africa?
Yeah, they came in, Animal Source Texas brought them in. Yeah, well, I'll show you that outside. We just built that. That's what I'm talking about. We're gonna try and build our chimp cages. It's a badass cage, I think.
And can you tell me a little bit about this little
division? That one I have?
Yeah.
Preston, come here. Came from a private individual. We've had him about 4 years. And he likes certain people. I can go in there and he can sit in my lap. Rinky could go in there and sit in his lap, but the girls, he hates the girls for some reason. And the rocking thing is only when you're not paying attention to him. Now listen to this big cat expert lady with the USDA. Try and tell me about primates and why this little primate is rocking on its little stuffy.
So he's housed by himself. Does he just have compatibility issues with the other one?
Well, we started out when he first came in, he came in with George.
Oh, okay.
So we had them together and then they started pulling the hair out of each other.
Oh, okay.
So we let George go stay with Malaya and they play through the cage enough. But still, every once in a while, he'll go sit next to there and let George pull his hair out.
Okay.
So we keep him by himself because everybody pulls his hair out.
Okay. He looks pretty good
right now. Yeah, he's got a good coat back. But there's times of the year where he'll sit there and let him pluck him bald. Hi.
My girls are scary, aren't they?
Yeah. Right. And what's funny is, whenever you're in the cage and he's sitting on your lap, he sticks his finger up his nose and makes himself sneeze. Yeah, get the blankets off the floor.
I need to go ahead and finish this floor. So if I...
Again?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. When was the last time you guys did them?
God.
Was that after?
Yeah, it was after your last inspection. I emailed you those pictures.
Okay.
And we'll have to hope for a warm day again. Okay. Normally, we wouldn't do it again until close to March.
You're done when you
can. If I can do it, pull it off. Oh, yeah. Okay. If I can pull it off.
Not terrible, but...
Key thing about getting through a USDA inspection, first thing, keep your mouth shut. When they ask you a question, it's either yep, nope, or you get them just going in a different direction and change the subject entirely. And trust me, they'll forget what they were asking you. Ligers can climb, let me tell you.
Ligers can climb? Well, I would highly recommend it for the ligers.
Ligers can climb. See, these two right here are climbers. That's why we've got them completely enclosed. You know, we got this one 16 all the way around.
All right.
And then some places it's even 18.
Okay.
We just made it level.
Great. I'm trying to document the fence height on everything. So you carcass feed some of these guys.
In the back here, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, see, today's my day to clean this out.
All righty.
It looks like it snows in here every once in a while.
I could probably have
a couple of fast days.
Yeah,
come here, guys. Come here, Jagger. Come on, Jack. Come on. Three of us.
Uh-huh.
All of these guys on this section right here just got cows this morning.
How many cows do you have?
A lot.
It's over 100.
So we have just tigers. I think our inventory we just counted last week is 9 tigers.
Oh.
So what's the difference with the wolf hybrid dog thing? What'll change on those?
Dog red, basically, for you where it's gonna apply is like with their bedding, stuff like that. If the temperature drops below a certain level at night, they have to have bedding in their enclosures. You know,
do they?
The other thing is shipping ages. Dogs need cats.
We don't ship any of them anyway.
Okay. But if you sold one, it has to be 8 weeks old before it can ship. Okay. That's a hard task.
Even if they pick it up? Oh, okay. Yep. See, on cats, they can pick them up younger. It's just you can't ship them.
No, they can't. Yeah, they can't leave.
Until they're 8 weeks. So, straw consider baiting?
Yeah.
Okay,
absolutely.
We'll get that in all of them. And that cage of three males over there that I tried to get up, they're the same way. And see, those are the ones that Nancy says don't worry as much about raising their cages because they can't even walk, let alone climb.
Yeah, I agree. They're lower priority.
And so that's how come we haven't been in such a hurry for their cages.
I would put them on a higher on the list if you're going to be putting sand in. The sand does seem to help because it's softer for them to walk on. So it gives them a little bit softer substrate. It does seem to help some of them. Some of them, it doesn't do anything. So you've got a liger and a lion.
Yeah, trying. Hey!
This is kind of creepy. I mean, it looks like a body.
Yeah, this is our trauma. That's human food there.
That's human food?
Yeah.
Okay.
And our skeleton alligator. Calcium carbonate is what it is.
Yeah, right, that's good.
We're back, a 50-pound bag.
Oh, I see. So, and your vet has figured out about how much you have to eat each
When you saw him, his legs should have been still bowed.
They were really bowed.
Yeah.
Oh, he's
in
with the dog.
Oh, yeah.
Look, you guys are all good friends.
What's this one up here?
This one?
Yeah.
That's just my personal cat. To my baby. This is my baby. All right, I need everybody to pay really close attention here. This is why you never open your mouth and suggest anything to a USDA inspector. Keep in mind, this lady is their big cat expert. And Carol Baskin, the HSUS, and every animal rights people out there think that it's a law that you can only pet tiger cubs between 8 and 12 weeks old. Now, this lady right here is the authority for the USDA. And she's fixing to tell you, the world, that it's fine to play with tiger cubs up to 16 weeks old, and maybe even bigger if you're not playing with children.
It really depends on the skills of the handler, the demeanor of the animal, if they're, you know, aggressive or super active or mellow. You know, some of them are just more mellow than others. Some of them are smaller than others, like that one looks a little smaller. So, you know, it has a lot to do with that, and once they hit 16 weeks...
Nancy always told me between 8 and 16 weeks. She told me to use my best judgment.
Use your best
judgment. Because I've had 9-week-old tigers that would just nip the hell out of you.
Exactly, and those are the ones you don't want to use.
And I've had 14-week-old cubs that were better than 9-week-old cubs.
And that's what we look for. Some 12-week-old cubs are just not suitable. They're just too aggressive. They're too nasty. They're too something to be used with the, you know, with members of the public. Now, some of these animals that get a little bigger, they're 16 weeks old, but what we really don't want to see is a larger animal approaching this size being used around any children.
So these two were bad their whole life.
Yeah. So
they were just born evil.
And that's just it. You have to use good judgment, and the people who don't are the ones that cause problems for everybody else. And then we don't like to see cubs that are too young. mean, if they're really, if they're under, we really like to see them be 8 weeks old and have to be vaccinated before they start to be handled by the public. If they're, you know, if they're really young, if they're 6 weeks or younger, it's just too young for them to, you know, handled by members of the public. Love me. And I thought, you know, I've been so careful all day and I still get a fire ant.
They come from all directions.
I just
can't
believe it.
Okay, this is our book. Okay. Best book, Trey's book.
Okay.
And these are just inspection reports and things in here.
And our protocols, our escape protocols.
Oh, great. Okay. I'll just sort of...
Trey has one lion.
One lion, two tabbies, a male and a female.
7 months.
Okay.
Maybe.
So you've been there about a year and a half.
About a year and a half.
So almost a year.
Almost
basically,
a year. Yeah.
Of being...
So you would not ever turn a new employee loose to work by themselves or shift a cat or anything like that?
So were you one of the key holders
at the time.
This time then? Okay.
Yep.
And the key holders are. The most experienced personnel.
Some people that's been here 2 years, it'll never be a key holder.
Yeah,
right.
It's
just time. Got it. It's a matter of trust.
Yep.
Okay.
We got one training right now, but he's responsible enough to do the wolves and the dingoes and stuff, you know, as a key holder.
Right.
But as far as a tiger, you can tell him every day. I can reach in a cage and milk a tiger, vaccinate a tiger, you know, because I've trained them to do that.
When you say milk a tiger, do you actually milk the tigers?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Can you believe this woman? Through the cage.
Oh, okay.
How
much milk can you get from a tiger?
Well, I mean, we can see if they're lactating to see how close they are.
Oh, I thought you might be milking them for their partner.
No.
Wow, I've never heard anybody doing that.
That would be interesting.
So you just want to see if they're lactating.
We have certain ones that we can draw blood with through the cage, vaccinate them through the cage, and then some of the staff see us doing that, and they're like, oh, well, this thing's tame. And it's just... You gotta beat it in their fucking head every day that, dude, I've been doing this 30 years and these cats know us, okay? And the guy that's out there right now, you gotta tell him every day, get your fucking hands off the cages. After 7 hours of the USDA being here, now it's time to start all the repairs, suggestions, and requirements that they are gonna make us do. One, raising our cages to 16 feet. Congratulations, USDA. You just cost me another $80,000. Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. another fun episode of What Goes On in a Day of My Life. Stay tuned tomorrow night on JoeExoticTV.com and let's see just what kind of questions we can answer next time. So y'all get out there and play with all them baby tigers up to 16 weeks old, because the big cat expert with the USDA said it was okay.